Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. The Ritva writes that Tchilas Kol Davar, the beginning of all learning, Roi La'odim Lilmoid L'Lami Levanov, it is best if a parent teaches his children and a teacher teaches his students. The first thing is say the brachas. What is the proper bracha for each food? K'dei Shele Yavoyu L'dei Me'ila. So God forbid, if somebody eats without brachas, He's transgressing the Isser of Me'ilah, which means using hektish, as the Gemara says in Brachas Daf Lamed Hey Amud Aleph, Aser Lo La'Adam Sheyenem and Elam Hazeh B'Lei Bracha. It's prohibited for a person to benefit from any Hanah from Elam Hazeh without making a Bracha, and if you do so, it's as if you're using Kachay Shemaim, and if you do so, Rachman Latlan, is as if you are Goyzel HaKadosh Baruch Hu Knesses Yisrael. That's what the Gemara says. And the Ritva says, it's the most important thing to start teaching. This is a very harsh halacha. And Taka the Gemara says, Amar Rava, the Rava said, Yelech Eitz HaChacham, everybody should try to go to HaChacham, the Yelamdenu Dinei Brachas, the Chacham should teach you the halachas of Brachas, Kideish LeYavoyu Dei Me'ila. So it shouldn't, Rachman Alatlan, be using Hashem's property, Hekdesh's property. Now we know that everybody knows that there's typical brachas when you make a shahako, when you make a eitz, when you make a dhamma, but it's a very complex and detailed halacha. And obviously on one foot you can't teach that. But I want to stop on something, especially in proximity to Tu B'Shvat, where people are going to be eating fruit, it's a minhag Yisrael to eat fruit, maybe a halacha which is attached to this. You know that when you do make the bracha, every bracha you make, It has to be made without an hefsek. A hefsek means right after the bracha, you do the act of the mitzvah. In this case, after the bracha, right away you should eat. And it shouldn't be a hefsek. So the Mishnah Berurah writes in Simon Reish Vav, Sif Katan Yud Gimel, the Mishnah Berurah says, La yivarech al maichol oy mashke shehu cham oy kar b'yoyser. Don't make a bracha on a food item which is either very hot or very cold, because you just made a bracha, and then you're not going to be able to drink it or eat it because it's too hot. Mishum chshash hefsik. Or another example he brings, that if somebody's going to eat a food, and it might be untasty to him, even if it's untasty, at least eat something, so the bracha should not be a bracha levatola. Even those who have the minig, that they don't drink from a cup unless they pour some out first, make sure to do that before the making of the bracha. Fine, those are general things that you hear, which seems to be not so relevant. How about a very relevant shaila? Eating fruit. So obviously, we know what on apples and oranges, and we make ha'etz. We say the bracha of ha'etz. But not everybody likes to eat the peel of the orange, the peel of the apple, the peel of the banana. And some of the peels are edible. Some of the peels are not edible. So here there is a dilemma. The dilemma is, if I make the bracha first and then peel the fruit, then there is a hefsek between eating the bracha and eating. If I make the bracha after peeling, I'm losing out on the fact that during the bracha, it's best if the fruit that you make the bracha on is a shalem, is more complete. So the Mishnah Berurah says, Kishe'eichel egoiz, when you're about to eat nuts, or something that has that hard shell, yishberena, first break it, crack it, v'achar kach yivarech, and then make the bracha, because ein kedai lahafsik harbe ben habracha la'achila. It's not right to make a big hafsik with cracking the nuts. It's too much of a hafsik. But then he gives a second reason. V'oid, perhaps, shema lo'im tse'ena yafa, maybe he'll make the bracha, and then he'll crack the nuts, and he'll see inside, oh, it's not good. It's not a tasty one. It's not good looking. He won't want to eat it. So you'd rather want him to see the inside of the fruit, the inside of the nut, to know if he's going to eat it, because he might find out that it's Eina Ruya Lebracha, and therefore, crack the nuts first. So the Mishnah Berurah actually brings two reasons why something like that, you crack the peel, you crack the cover, the shell first. The two reasons are either because of it shouldn't be a hefsek after the bracha. The second reason, you might find it not being pleasant enough to eat. When you look in the Alter Rebbe Shulchan Aruch, Siman Reish Vav Sif Gimel, he says, he brings this halacha, but he says only one reason. He says, Lefichach ha-mevarech ala peri. If somebody makes a bracha on a fruit, v'choytech mimenu v'oichel, and he cuts the fruit and then he eats it, lo yachtoich ad achar ha-bracha. It's actually better not to peel the fruit, not to cut the fruit until it's after you made the bracha. Kidei sheyevarech al ha-sholim. It's better to make a bracha on a complete item. L'mitzvah min ha-muvcher, that the bracha is said in a nicer fashion on a complete item. Ah, there might be a hefsik, says the Alter Rebbe. Ve'ein lachush lehefsik shias achituch ben ha-bracha la'achila. Don't worry about the time that's going to be after you make the bracha to peel the apple, peel the orange. Because hayul v'hu tzayrech achila. Because it's all part, it's not considered a hefsik, it's all part of how you eat. However, eichel egois, if you are going to eat a nut or something like that, that yishberenu, that I want you to crack first and then make the bracha, because over there you can't see the inside, and maybe there's worms in the inside, and it's rotten in the inside, so it's not noticeable, and there's more chances that the bracha might be a bracha levatala. But when it comes to the hefsik, the Alter Rebbe does not consider the hefsik a problem. Now, when you look in Shari Tshuva in the beginning of Reish Beis, he sort of makes possibly a difference between the types of fruits. There are two types of fruits and vegetables, the peels of those fruits and vegetables. There are some peels that are ru'uya l'achila, that you're able to eat. And there are some peels that are not ru'uya l'achila. And yet there are some that even after you take off the peel, it doesn't diminish, it doesn't make the size of the peri smaller. So this, to summarize it, take an example, apples, pears, carrots, cucumbers, those, even if you peel it, it doesn't diminish the shalim. So they suggest that might be better if you peel before the bracha, because even after you took off the peel, it's still a shalim. There are those that suggest, and they say the Chassam Sofer used to do the same, to peel a little before the bracha, and you leave it complete. You leave it whole together until after you make the bracha, so it should look like a shalim. If it's a type of fruit or vegetable that the peeling takes a very, very long time, for example, a watermelon, a cantaloupe, it's not chick-chock, so over there, the Achrayim definitely suggests that you should do that first, even though we said the Alter Rebbe said that the hefsik of peeling is not considered a hefsik, but a long time and a hard, difficult thing to cut, like a watermelon or something big like that, that might be considered a hefsik. So you should make the bracha after it's already peeled.